Hi guys, welcome to another PC Advisor video, and we're going to take a look at the differences between the LG G2, one of the best smartphones from last year, and the brand new LG G3. So obviously this is the new version of LG's flagship Android smartphone, and you're probably wondering what the differences are. So because the G2's been around for a little while now, you can get it for less than £300 on a SIM-free basis. The LG G3 is going to launch at the beginning of July, and as far as we know, it's going to cost £499, so it's a little bit less than rival smartphones. So as you can see, the phone hasn't actually got that much bigger compared to the G2. It's a little bit taller and a little bit wider, but you can see that the screen is bigger. So LG has done another good job of keeping the bezels very small. It's actually no bigger than rival devices such as the Galaxy S5 and Xperia Z2. We've only put on a few grams of weight, so the LG G2 is 143 grams and the G3 is only 149. And according to our measurements, it's actually got a little bit slimmer. So it's just under 9mm, and we've measured the G2 at just over 9mm. It's not a noticeable difference, but nevertheless, it has got a tiny bit smaller. So just to carry on talking about design, we've still got the rear buttons. So LG does something a little bit different. Instead of putting the buttons on the top or the sides of the phone, you've got the power and volume buttons on the back underneath the camera. So that's the same on the G3. And I'm launching some Google voice activations by accident. So your finger naturally rests at the back there, and this time the buttons are a little bit subtle, they don't stick out as much, but the design is basically the same. Instead of a plastic rear cover, we've got this metallic finish. So it is a plastic rear cover, which now comes off. It didn't before on the G2. So as you can see, it is a plastic cover, but they've applied what they call a metallic skin. So we've got this kind of brushed aluminium finish, which does feel and look quite nice, if not as nice as proper metal phones like the HTC One M8, but it is a step up from the G2. And removing the rear cover gives you access to things like the battery, which we'll talk about later. So the screen is one of the main differences between the two phones. So we have, as we mentioned, got a little bit bigger. We've gone from 5.2 inches to 5.5 inches. So it may sound like this is a bit of a phablet, but as you can see, the phone has not got much bigger due to those tiny bezels. The resolution has also increased from Full HD to Quad HD, so that is 1440 by 2560 on the G3, which is the highest resolution you'll find on any smartphone. In terms of storage, we've still got 16 and 32 gigabyte models for each, but there is a marginal difference because the G3 comes with either 2GB or 3GB of RAM, depending on which storage model you buy. One of the things we didn't like about the G2 was the fact that it didn't have a microSD card slot for adding more storage by way of a memory card. But because we've got the removable rear cover on the G3, we have now, as you can see, got a microSD card slot there, and you can put up to 128GB inside. There's a marginal upgrade when it comes to the processor, so we've moved from a Snapdragon 800 processor on the G2 up to a Snapdragon 801. It's a small difference, but it's there nevertheless, and we've gone from 2.3 GHz up to 2.5 GHz on the G3. We've not noticed a massive difference in performance, because at the end of the day, they're both flagship phones, and the processor's doing a little bit more work on the G3 with the higher res screen. Pretty much the same in terms of wireless specs, so not that we can show you, but there is NFC in both, Wi-Fi up to 11ac, Bluetooth 4 low energy, and we've got an infrared blaster on the top of both phones, so you can control things like your TV. On the camera front, we've got the same 2 megapixel camera on the front for you taking your selfies. And on the back, the camera is still 13 megapixels on the G3, so no change in resolution, although LG does say that the sensor is better, but there's a couple of differences to point out. So we've got a dual tone flash, a bit like the iPhone 5S, so you've got one yellow and one orange for more natural looking photos when you do use the flash. And on this side, we've got a laser autofocus, which means that the phone can focus on your subject a lot quicker than before. Still got optical image stabilization, which has been improved from the G2. So moving on to software, the G2 is now running Android 4.4 KitKat via an upgrade, so we're running KitKat on the G3 as you would expect, but as you can see the interface does look quite different. LG has gone for the circle as a motif running throughout the software. So if I open the drop down notification bar, you'll see we've got a slightly different looking interface. Everything's now circles, everything looks quite flat, a little bit like iOS 7, and we've got new animations such as this kind of paper style one, and the LG G3 can track your steps a bit like other rival smartphones without the need for a separate device. New features such as smart tips, which tells you things about the phone like any apps that you haven't used in a long time, and things like that. Because the screen is quite big, you can run apps side by side, which you couldn't do on the G2. And last but not least, battery. You might think that the G3 will offer pretty poor battery life because of that mega high res screen, and although the battery is still exactly the same capacity as the G2, we found that the battery life is just as good. So you're going to get a good couple of days battery life unless you watch a lot of videos or play games. And because we've got that removable cover, the battery is also removable, which wasn't the case on the G2. So you can carry a spare, or if this battery starts to die, you can buy a replacement and easily swap it over. In the case, we've also got wireless charging built in, which the G2 didn't have. So that's another bonus if you're going to upgrade to the G3. So there's a look at the specs and differences between the old LG G2 and the new LG G3.